begin with Mr. Posey.
Mr. Posey likes dogs, so I like dogs.
Mr. Posey likes coffee, so I like coffee.
Mr. Posey likes Call of Duty, so I like Call of Duty.
Mr. Posey went to Goodrich, so I went to Goodrich.
Mr. Posey got plants, so I got plants.
Mr. Posey likes Star Wars, so I like Star Wars.
Well, Mr. Posey went to MSU, and that's why I went to MSU.
I'm Mr. Posey.
What do you teach, and what is your room number?
I am in room number 605. I teach economics and world history, and I'm a first-year teacher here at Grand Blanc.
What did you do before coming to Grand Blanc?
I started at Michigan State, and then right as COVID hit, I switched and I went to Ferris and I graduated from Ferris.
How was your first semester here in Grand Blanc?
First semester was awesome. It was really fun meeting the kids and kind of getting the layout of the school and how things run. It was nice.
What do you think of the corner?
I love the corner. A lot of students tell me that they're intimidated by it, but I like the corner because it's all my friends are there and all the teachers are there and we just kind of hang out and have a good time.
Why did you pick history out of all the other subjects to teach?
I always liked history. I liked the fact that you get to kind of research facts and learn about stuff that already happened and how it has an impact on today. So that kind of just made sense once I switched to teaching to just go into history.
What's your favorite thing in your classroom?
My favorite thing in my classroom is my plant. It's a Monstera plant, also known as a Swiss cheese plant. His name is Eduardo, and I've had him for 3 years. I like my duck collection. Still collecting if you've got any extra to give.
This is 5 school rules that you might not know existed.
Oh my God, it's that kid Gupta, I hate him.
I got it, it's that loser Drew, bro.
Oh, these kids are about to fight. I'm gonna video it and send it to my friends.
Yo, what's good?
Stop. Fighting is never okay, but neither is filming a fight. Bryce O'Mara is violating a school rule by filming this fight and will get an ISS.
Aw, man, this guy's vaping. I gotta go search him. He's gonna be in real trouble. Excuse me, sir, I gotta search that bag. I believe you have something in there.
If an administrator has reasonable suspicion, you and your belongings can be searched at any point in time.
Hey, Mr. Ann, I'm about to go to the bathroom. I'm about to make my pass real quick.
You know, I already went out twice today. It's probably my third time. I can get out of class whenever I want.
You're only allowed 2 smart passes a day. If you're caught in the hallways without a smart pass, there will be consequences.
Wow. So, not appropriately dressed for school for just a few reasons. First of all, the shorts are not nearly long enough. They should be to at least the bottom of our fingertips, which is somewhere in the mid-thigh. Also, when I look at the shirt, we really need some type of sleeve structure, especially for our male students, as underarm hair is not something that we want to see in school. So for our males, we would prefer a full, a sleeve over the shoulder, but definitely shorts that go to at least the mid-thigh, bottom of the fingertips.
Man, I'm really late to school this morning. I'm just going to park in the teacher's lot.
If you are caught parking in the teacher's lot, you will get a parking ticket and your car will be towed.
That's it right there. That's it right there.
I think I am the smartest person in this class.
The smartest person in this class is Anthony Andre.
So it's definitely not Goop. I think it's Aiden.
I think Max Merrill's probably the smartest in the class.
I think Anthony Andre is the smartest in GBTV.
That will be myself.
I think Tony Dre is gonna win.
No glaze, but I think Aiden White is the smartest kid in the class.
The smartest person in the class is probably Aiden White.
I think the smartest person in the class is Aiden White.
I think either Anthony Andre or Aiden White is the smartest in the class.
My vote for the second smartest person in this room would be Max Merrill, right there, number two.
Gupta is the smartest person in the class.
I think the smartest is Max.
Yo, I'm the smartest kid in the GBTV classroom.
Stop the cap!
I'm the smartest kid in the GBTV classroom.
Dinosaurs?
180 degrees.
7 to 1.
7 to 1 ratio?
Or 1 to 7, you know what I mean.
Moose.
Octagon.
I was gonna say octagon.
Elizabeth? That's English.
That's Britain.
Oh, there we are, that's not.
The Roman Empire.
Thomas Edison.
Arizona.
China.
Mercury.
The Mayans.
No, it wasn't.
The Incans. Milky Way.
I knew that question.
He was probably smarter than we used to
be. Yeah, actually.
Spanish.
What the hell?
I don't even know how to pronounce it. Coal? I don't know. No. Oil.
Coal.
Diamond? Atlantic. Adjective? Invertebrates. Hey, I'm Maxwell Merrill, and this would mean not that much to me. I'm Goop. I had a lot of haters, so, you know, I'm just happy to be a podium finalist, and, yeah.
Dude, I know this.
I know what the type of writing is called. I don't know what theirs is, though. I know what the... Hieroglyphs?
Forgiveness. The action or process of forgiving or being forgiven.
According to Johns Hopkins Medicine, 62% of Americans say they need more forgiveness in their lives. Some people say forgive and forget, but it's easy to forget. It's hard to forgive. We asked GB what their experiences with forgiveness were, and here they are.
Forgiveness to me is something that was hard to forgive. I guess I would go back to when my dad moved out of state when I was in kindergarten. That was something that was always a struggle for me to deal with because I didn't quite understand why he left. So I was always angry about that. But as I got older, I just realized that that was the best life decision for him to make. And that, you know, he still loved me. So knowing that he still loved me and then just falling back on my faith, I was able to forgive him. I would say that you just have to take a walk in their shoes. You have to be able to realize what other people are going through. Someone can be going through that's something that's difficult in their life. You have to be able to see different people's perspectives, and that definitely makes it a lot easier to forgive people.
Try to think on their side of the story. And then if you still can't forgive them, I mean, then you just can't.
Listen, there was one day that Steven was trying to give me a hug, and in his kindness, he ended up knocking down my water bottle, my coffee, actually, not my water bottle, and busting it. But I forgive you, Steven.
When I was in high school, I had a Mr. Pierce in room 617 for sociology, and he told me I'd never make it someday. I'd never be a teacher, I'd never be successful, and I've never forgave him. And look where I am. I'm a teacher here at Grand Blanc, so I'm happy I overcame. For people that struggle with forgiveness, I say use it as motivation, like I did. Become a teacher and prove your doubters wrong.